write a book, I really want to focus very deeply on things that fit the subject matter. You know, so if I'm writing a book on seduction, I'm just going to read everything I can about great seducers from any kind of environment, anything that's appropriate. So this book is based on a couple of ideas or themes. And one of the themes is that people who come from difficult circumstances are often have an advantage in life, which is something that's kind of counterintuitive. We think of, oh, I wish I was born to privilege, or my father had more money and could send me to the great school and blah, blah, blah. So many times in life that's a great disadvantage. Coming from a poor environment where you have nothing makes you understand what is important in life. It gives you ambition and drive and energy. You have to succeed. So a huge theme in the 50th law is of Black America and the struggles that Black Americans have had, because they have had to deal with fear in a very visceral manner that's much different from white people in America. Fear of policemen, of suffering brutality, I'm talking not too long ago in our past, of being lynched, of just actual violence happening to them. And overcoming that fear was an incredibly interesting idea to me, because 50 exemplifies it. So I looked at some of the great icons in African American history, and they're in this book, great boxers like Joe Louis or Joe Johnson, people like Frederick Douglass. But then I was looking, wanting to move beyond and look at like writers and people like that, the great intellectuals in African American culture. And certain ones I was drawn to, and certain ones didn't seem to fit as well. So someone like Ralph Ellison, who's a great writer and wrote the book The Invisible Man, his way of looking at the world wasn't quite meshing with the theme of this book. But Richard Wright, he really did. And it's because Richard Wright really came from an almost impossible environment, like 50. He was born in the Deep South. His father, his mother raised him. His uncle was lynched by a mob when he was a young man. And his books, like Black Boy, which is his autobiography, a great book, are just, he talks about fear over and over and over and over again, and how much a part it was of his life as a young man, and how much it molded him. And ultimately, in the book, The Native Son, he overcame that last bit of fear that was kind of destroying him, in the sense that he'd always wanted to make his books palatable to a white audience. He is the first best-selling author, African-American author, in the history of the United States. And he was tied to that idea. He wanted to sort of please and appeal to wider audiences, but it was making him upset, and he was fearful. And finally, in The Native Son, he decided he would let go of that fear and write a book that was so brutal, so honest, and almost just so violent that no white audience could kind of paper it over and say, oh, he's giving us a nice message, or see into it what they wanted to see. It was impossible. He did that, and it was his most successful novel of all time. And it's one of those fundamental lessons in this book, that when you're actually bolder with your actions, when you overcome fears that are holding you back, you're going to have more success in life. Being all pinched and conservative and trying to be like other people and worrying about how to please them, it's really what's holding you back. And when you let go of that and you're actually brutal in what you do, or more honest, or more bold, you're going to have more success in life. And Richard Wright showed that. And, you know, I have other people, icons like James Baldwin in this book, but I really bonded with Richard Wright, and a lot of things that happen in my books are, there's a writer that I bond with, and I feel like we're kindred spirits, like Machiavelli.